In this section, we're going to find the center radius form of a circle tangent to the x-axis. To find the center radius form of a circle tangent to the y-axis. A tangent line is a line in the same plane as the circle that intersects a circle at exactly one point. A tangent to a circle is perpendicular to the radius at the point of tangency. If a circle is tangent to the x-axis, such as in this case, then your y value, k, is going to be the center point, the y value k of the center point is going to be the radius of the circle. So again, here we have a circle that is tangent, that touches here, notice, on the x-axis, so it's tangent to the x-axis, which means that if we were to move over on the coordinate system over x and up y, whatever our y value is here is going to be the radius of the circle. In this example, we're asked to find the center radius form of the equation of a circle with a center of 3, 2, tangent to the x-axis. So tangent to the x-axis, here we see a circle that is tangent to the x-axis. So all we need to do is identify what the radius is. We already have our center. To write an equation of a circle, the two things you need is the center and you need the radius. To find the radius, as long as it's tangent to the x-axis, all you have to do is find out what your y value is. So to move over to that circle in the center, from the point of origin, I would need to move over 3. And we're just following the point that we were given, 3, 2 for our center. Over 3 and up 2. So our y value here then is going to be our radius of our circle of 2. So we can plug everything in, and what we'll have for our circle, putting it in the x minus h squared quantity squared plus y minus k quantity squared equals r squared form. Let's go ahead and plug in our points. So we're going to have x minus 3 plus y minus k equals 2 squared. So lastly, all we have to do is simply square 2. 2 squared is 4 on the right side. And there you have your equation of a circle that is tangent to the x-axis. In this example, we're asked to find the center radius form of the equation of a circle with a center of negative 6, negative 5, and tangent to the y-axis. So tangent to the y-axis means, as you can see in the diagram, that the circle is going to touch or intersect the y-axis at one point. The center of that circle is negative 6, negative 5, and the radius of this circle has a distance, the distance from the center, negative 6, negative 5, to the y-axis. So again, let's go ahead and find our distance, our center. Our center is over 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and down 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So that's our center at that point. So the radius would be this distance from where we are now, which is the center, all the way to the y-axis. So we would move over to the y-axis, and that was 6 units, okay? So you're just moving over to that edge point, and that is your radius. So all you have to do is, in this case, take your x value when it's tangent to the y-axis, because that would be your radius. We were already given the center, so you only need two things to write an equation of a line. So we have the center, which was given to us, and we just discovered that our radius is 6, and 6 units, that distance. And even though you see negative 6 as the value, you won't say the radius is negative 6. We're talking about distance here, how many units it is from the center to the edge outer circle, which is the y-axis there, and that's 6 units. So we use the positive of that. And now to go ahead and put it into the equation of a circle form, we can say it's going to be x minus, let's see, what's our x value? X minus negative 6 squared plus y minus negative 5 squared equals 6 squared. Remember, double negatives become positive, so our equation of the circle then is going to be x plus 6 squared plus y plus 5 squared equals 36, because when we square 6, we get 36. And there you have it, an equation of a circle that is tangent to the y-axis.